As with all live-action adaptations of a beloved webhead, each had their own unique take on the iconic costume. So, let's travel back in time to the year 2012. Enter the Amazing Spider-Man 1 suit. This suit belongs to Peter Parker of Earth 120703, aka the Amazing Spider-Man movie series. The suit was adapted to be a more modern interpretation of the classic comic book costume. In the events of the film, Peter decided to ditch the rugged street look for a more streamlined approach. According to director Mark Webb, he wanted a Spider-Man suit that looked better at nighttime. The suit was supposedly made out of spandex, as Peter was previously looking for inspiration online from various sports. The process of making the suit's design was done via screen printing, which is a technique where mesh is used to transfer ink onto the desired surface. The eyes were made out of sunglasses with some sort of golden mesh that were glued onto the mask and were further applied with the blue frame. As with the Raimi films, the eyes are still expressionless. The soles of the boots were taken from the ASICS Gel Dirt Dog 3, a shoe specifically designed for track and field. The web shooters, on the other hand, were externally located on the wrist rather than being underneath the suit like in the comics. Not only that, but the web shooter was completely redesigned, being much smaller, and were made using parts from an old watch. Compared to previous live-action iterations, the spider logo was the exact same on the front and back. It was also much bigger, with the bottom portion extending all the way to the lower area of the torso. Its design also featured broken or dotted lines. As opposed to Raimi's version of the Spider-Man suit, both the blue and red sections have hexagonal mesh that were added to emphasize the look, as well as black outlines around the torso, arms, and legs. Furthermore, this didn't have a belt that connected around the whole waist, instead being left completely open at the front. What made this quite unique was that it added some sort of practicality to the design, if you take into account from the lenses and boots. I have a feeling that this was supposed to be like a semi-homemade costume. The suit's final appearance is in the Amazing Spider-Man Cinematic Infinite comic, where it gets destroyed in battle after he falls into some sort of giant centrifuge. In previous events leading up to this, Gwen even suggested to Peter to change the look, which leads to the creation of the Amazing Spider-Man 2 suit, which had a more simplistic, comic book accurate design. Seriously, those lenses are what made this so special. However, he does make a reappearance in Spider-Verse as well as Spider-Geddon, where it was shown that he was wearing the suit from the first film. This could possibly mean that he joined the Spider Army before the events of the Amazing Spider-Man 2. Or maybe he's from a divergent timeline, but I suppose we'll never know. Till this day, many people would consider the Amazing Spider-Man films to produce the best live-action adaptations of the costume. The first one did receive mixed opinions, with some citing that they disliked the lenses because of its size, and that the yellowish colors were also painful to look at. However, it was praised for the new take on the classic costume. This suit features in both the Amazing Spider-Man and the Amazing Spider-Man 2 video game adaptations. This was also available on the PS4 Spider-Man game known as the Amazing Suit, which was provided via the 1.19 game update. Hope you enjoyed another Spider-Man suit origin. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more Marvel-related content.